folks, welcome back to Jerome Bee Farm and Homestead. It's February 8th, and it's a beautiful day here in central Oklahoma. It's almost 60 degrees, and hey, today is my dad's birthday, so put in the comments down below, happy birthday, Lyle Jerome, and he'll get a kick out of that. So today, this video, the prior video, it was nice like this last weekend, and through the week we had a cold northerly come through. It got down in the teens for 2 days and we got 5 inches of snow, but you can see it's all gone now. And fortunately I wasn't here, I was gone all week. I was in Houston and it was pretty nice down there. It got down into the 40s one day and people were like all bundled up in their stocking caps and stuff, and I was walking around in a jacket going, what's y'all's problem? So anyway, in this video we are going to check on our two weakest hives. So last video you saw I rescued hive number 18. It was so light I could lift it with 2 fingers. Put some pollen patties in there and sugar, and we're going to check on it and see if it made it through that cold spell. And also we're going to check on our nuke hive combine number 1 and 5 over there. I didn't look at it last time I did inspections. I just passed it on over. So let's get going and check on these and see how they look. A few folks were asking about the house and how it's coming along, so there's kind of a shot of it. So the brick is all done, outside is pretty much done. They are finished drywalling and they're texturing inside right now, and they ought to be done texturing in the next couple of days. So that's what she looks like right now. So here's the entrance to our hive number 1, 5 combined. I see a couple bees coming and going. Let's get in there and see what we find. Well, I can see bees up here eating on the sugar. Got a few ants back in here too. Give them a little bit of smoke, calm them down. They're a little defensive. Okay, so they're working on that sugar pretty good. And it's hollow right in there. So I took that big chunk of sugar out to get that pollen patty in there. They're munching on it pretty good. Let's go ahead and pop that top and see what they look like in there. I really want to see the bottom of this pollen patty without lifting it. And they're working on it right here. So we got a good cluster of bees on this frame right here on both sides, basically. Not much over here. I'm not going to open it. Get some of this pollen patty and put right on top of them. And they are not happy. Let's get them closed up. So real quick, before I get out of this hive, I want to look down on the bottom board and see if I see a bunch of dead bees down there. because that cluster wasn't very big. Let's see if I can lift this up and check it without having to break it open in the middle. If I can get my fingers under there and see. No, it's clean. There's a little bit of granulated sugar down there. So we don't have a lot of dead loss in here, which is good. So this little hive is holding its own. If we don't have any more really cold weather, I think it's gonna pull through. And it has a decent queen in it, I believe. So we'll just see how it goes, and we'll check it again in a week. Get this fence put back, keep the skunks away. I remember if it was last year or the year before I had a hive like this. It was just about to make it through and a skunk got after it, and that was the end of it. Okay, this here's hive number 18. This is the one I could lift with two fingers. It doesn't weigh anything. And I got some sugar cakes on here and some pollen patties. And we got bees going in and out the entrance. I did reduce the entrance down to the small little 1-inch hole. So they're working on the pollen patty here and the sugar. So looks like they've survived. Got the sun in the way here. Yeah, so they look good. I was concerned they may not make it through that cold weather. But right in there is where they're really working on it. And they're eating on the sides of that pollen patty and the sugar. So yeah, they're working on it pretty good. Looks like they're working on that pollen patty right there from the edge. They haven't got out to these over here yet. Now there's a couple right there working on that one maybe. So I brought with me a internal feeder. So I'm gonna put that in there and give them some heavy syrup in addition to what they got now. Give them a little bit of smoke and I can get this feeder off the top. Get them to go down. Okay. Bees are right here. So I'm gonna put this feeder right here. Actually, I think I'm gonna put it right here. It's an empty frame. They've got honey right there. Let's pull that frame and look at it real quick. So look at that. They've got that big thing of honey on both sides. So they probably really don't need this feeder. Scoot them over. So we got pollen and a little bit of honey there. There's our capped brood. And our queen is there, and I see some uncapped larva. So I'm gonna get that back in there quick so they don't get chilled. So we got us a good queen. She's marked green. She is last year's queen. So we got us a good queen in here. Still wanna put that feed in here. I'm going to go ahead and put it on this opposite side of them here. There we go. So this is a heavy syrup. It's probably 3.5 to 1. Had trouble mixing it because my sugar was all crystallized. So I don't know the exact ratio. And it has some pro health in it. Feeding stimulant. This will get them going good. This feeder has ridges on the side, so bees won't drown. Already got one right here, chugging it down. To smoke these down and put the feeder back on, the sugar feeder. And we've got a screen over the front so other bees can't come in here and rob this. Okay, so we got a gallon of feed in there. We found the queen, the marked queen from last year. So we have us a young queen in here. So, and we had cap brood and I saw some uncapped larvae. So they're doing well. Tells me they were able to maintain their temperature over that uncapped larva through that cold spell. So that's pretty good. Even with that small a population in a double deep 10 frame hive there, so we were probably pushing the boundaries of them surviving that. So we got a gallon of feed in there for them. Reason I did that, I want to give them a good boost, and I considered doing some open feeding today, but I do in the summer I will harvest a few deep frames from hives that are kind of honey bound, and I don't want to get sugar water in my hives where I don't want it. So I try not to open feed, and it's kind of a crazy frenzy when you do that anyway. Sometimes it kills a few bees, not too many, but anyway, so we're gonna end this here. Hey, if you like my wildlife intros to my videos, I created a new channel, so go check that out. It's called Game Cam Wildlife Recon, and I'll put a link to that below in the description, so you can go check that out. So a lot of people like those videos, and when I do the just a wildlife video, seem like I lost a few subscribers, so I'm just going to put that over on its own thing and do it over there. So if you like that, go over there and check that out. So that's the end of the video. Hope you liked it. Be sure and subscribe before you leave, and we'll catch you on the next one. Take care.